and listen to each other. Now, sometimes these conversations, they just turn into an argument. Other times, people know just not to go there. Now, this story, it is not about one particular issue, and it's also not about one group of people or another. To prayer. It's part of everyday life for Samina Sohail and a part of her Islamic faith she never questioned growing up.
Obviously, I look different, but I never felt different.
Oh my God, there it goes!
September 11th, 2001, that changed.
When I grew up, I had never heard about Islamophobia. That was not even a term we knew about.
Things have gotten better since then, but not entirely.
The fear never goes away.
She says some days are worse than others, like on election day in 2016, when Sohail went to the polls to vote.
When somebody taunts me and says, build the wall, build the wall, build the wall, I mean, that's kind of scary, you know, and it kind of makes you feel bad too. Like, I never did anything to you. Why are you saying that to me?
The Islamic faith, it's just one example of a polarizing topic in America. It's a topic some people have trouble discussing, often sticking to one side. The religion is either good or bad.
No, KKK, no.
And there are other topics just like it.
I will give my life to end it.
We don't need walls.
There's a million other things that we could be doing right now than standing here trying to settle an issue that was resolved 50 damn years ago.
Immigration reform, gun rights, abortion, Black Lives Matter, and so many more. They're all issues some people struggle to talk about.
Politics is one.
Just the two basics, I think, politics and religion.
General race relations.
We spoke to people from different backgrounds who hold different perspectives right here in Cincinnati to get their take. Some tell us the lack of dialogue on these topics stems from a fear of being cast as the bad guy.
If you don't agree with the group, then you automatically see as an adversary.
Others say it's from an increase in hatred.
There's too much name-calling. There's too much bullying.
People we spoke with all believe without fixing the problem, communities could face devastating consequences.
I think that would turn us back to the medieval time. I think it's horrible.
Might even get worse in some cases.
So what does this mean, and what's the root cause? We went to a communication expert at Xavier University.
It is the heart of the crisis that we're facing as a culture right now.
James Buchanan is the executive director of the Brueggeman Center for Dialogue. The center studies communication and how we as a society discuss critical issues. He points to two main causes for collapses in communication. The information age and global influence.
In that world of that big open world, often we feel lost.
Now, for some people, the solution to that loss of identity is a term Buchanan refers to as tribalism. And what that means is finding a common connector with a group, whether that's race, gender, or class, and committing deeply to it. Now, some people take on the group's beliefs as the only answer and essentially close off dialogue on certain topics.
And we tend to pick our camps, stake our ground, and hold our ground, rather than living in that radical middle where dialogue takes place.
Buchanan says without more open dialogue, our country as we know it could drastically change.
If dialogue doesn't happen, democracy doesn't happen.
But he says there are ways to change what's currently happening.
Is there hope? Yes, of course there's hope.
In his eyes, the path to increasing dialogue and discussion on hot topics stems from communities coming together to collaborate on common projects or goals, like building a playground.
If we join together around that common purpose and do that work together, we'll return to dialogue. But what we'll find is the conversation has changed. We're now not so obsessed with the differences.
When it comes to religion, the Brueggeman Center helps with interfaith relations. That's something the Islamic Center of Greater Cincinnati is working hard to do. It's also using its own outreach program called Know Your Neighbor, where people are invited in to learn about the Islamic faith. Still, this work only addresses one issue in a world of many polarizing topics. And Samina Sohail believes across the board, there's a lot of work left to do.
Your thoughts become your actions, and we have to go after those thoughts.
Now, opening up dialogue is not necessarily about changing people's opinions, but about finding a common ground to move forward. Still, Buchanan says there are two topics the Center for Dialogue no longer holds sessions about. Those are abortion and the Israel-Palestine issue. Craig and Tanya, he says they've never been able to make any headway on those two issues.
That's very interesting, actually. I think that they decided, nope, we're not going to talk about those two issues. Really fascinating look, Marielle. Thanks so much.